So, in last video we have discussed in general about the classification of streptococci. So, today continuing the same, we will study the same more pathogenetic streptococci that are group B streptococci and group B streptococci. Group B and group D. In which we will study more or less the first Streptococcus aegylexia. Streptococcus aegylexia. And this belongs to Lancified group B and is the only species that carries the group B antigen. Previously, Streptococcus aegylexia was recognized primarily as a cause of bovine mastitis. Bovine means animal. Aegylexia means want of milk. In recent years, it has been recognized as the single most pathogen in neonates causing neonatal septicemia and meningitis. It may also cause septic aversion and purpureal sepsis. It's a common cell found in the vaginocervical tract of female carriers and the urethral mucous membranes of male carriers, and the transmission occurs from an infected mother to the infant at the time of birth. So now we will discuss about the clinical diseases which are occur due to this streptococci. The two different entities are recognized. One is early onset of disease and second is late onset of disease that occurs in neonates. Clinical symptoms of group B streptococcal infection acquired in uterus or at birth develop during the first week of life. Infection is acquired from the maternal vagina during birth. Early onset disease is characterized by bacteremia, pneumonia or meningitis and is often fatal. Late onset of disease. This type of infection develops between 2nd and 12th week of life. The prominent manifestation is bacteremia and meningitis. But septic arthritis may be occur. Diseases in older infants is acquired from exogenous sources, for example, mother or other infants. Other group B infectious diseases that occurs in neonates include osteoarthritis, myelitis, arthritis, conjunctivitis, sinusitis, otitis media, endocarditis and periostitis. These are the few common diseases that occur due to the infection of aegylexia, Streptococcus aegylexia. Now come to group B streptococci, that is known as Streptococcus. एंटीरोकोकस एंटीरोकोकस दिस वाज प्रीवियसली क्लासिफाइड एज ग्रुप डी स्ट्रेप्टोकोकाई. द स्ट्रेप्टोकोकाई ग्रुप हैज बीन रिक्लासिफाइड एज सेपरेट जीनस कॉल्ड एंटीरोकोकस. There are currently 16 species in this group. 16 species. This group consists of gram-positive cocci that are natural inhabitants of intestine, the tract of humans and animals. There are some characteristics of enterococci. These are also gram positive, and most of the in which we are talking about, they all are gram positive cocci and typically arranged in pairs and short chains, and these are not motile and non-capsulate. The cocci are facultatively anaerobic and grows optimally at 37 degrees centigrade. The temperature ranges 10 degrees centigrade to 45 degrees centigrade. They grow readily on blood agar media, in which they produce large white colonies in the incubation of 24 hours. The colonies are typically non-hemolytic, but can be a alpha hemolytic or beta hemolytic. They grow readily on ordinary media also, and McConkie agar, on which they form very small colonies, about 0.5 to 1 millimeter, and usually the color will be the magenta. The color of colonies will be magenta, and there are few distinctive features of this enterococci. They possess several distinctive features separating from other streptococci. They grow in the presence of 6.5% sodium chloride, 40% bile at pH of 9.6 at 45 degrees centigrade, and 1% methylene blue. It survives heating at 60 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes, and a feature distinguishing it from streptococci and also grows within a wider range of temperature, 10 to 45 degrees centigrade. These are pyrase test positive, PYRASE pyrase test, that we have discussed earlier, so no need to repeat again. They do not hydrolyze hippurate. Identification: these Enterococcus species is made up of biochemical characteristics. Enterococcus faecalis can be identified by its ability to ferment mannitol, sucrose, sorbitol, and esculin, and to grow on tailwhite blood agar, producing black colonies and gas products. So this can be identified by these characteristics. Now we will talk about the clinical manifestations. They inhabit the the gastrointestinal tract and the gastrointestinal tract in humans and other animals. These are frequently causes the nosocomial infections and may cause the urinary tract infection, bacteremia, infective endocarditis, biliary tract infection, intra-abdominal abscesses comprising the diverticulitis, peritonitis and wound infections. And other non-enterococcal species of group B are Streptococcus bovis and Streptococcus equinus. They cause urinary infection and endocarditis very rarely. Now the next Streptococcus viridans or viridans Streptococcus. The viridans streptococci are common cells of mouth and upper respiratory tract. These streptococci viridans are heterogeneous collection of alpha hemolytic and non hemolytic streptococci. This term viridis means green. Latin, this is the Latin name viridis, that means green, because many of these bacteria produce a green pigment, that is alpha hemolysis, on blood agar media. Some of them may be non-lytic, and viridans streptococci are fastidious with some strains requiring carbon dioxide for growth. These are again classified into four, that is anguinous group, metis group, mutans group and slivaris group. The clinical manifestations or infections that are caused by this group of streptococci, they are ordinarily non-pathogenic but can be occasion cause disease. And most important is dental caries and subacute endocarditis. And the dental caries are caused by S mutanosis. Mutans is the main cause of dental caries. So this is all about the Streptococcus group, and so thank you.